I've been traveling all over. But frankly, I just even stopping at gas stations and coffee shops, it's great because I get a chance to visit with people. And people have a lot on their mind right now. They're worried about healthcare. They're worried about the tariffs. They're worried about our economy as it relates to the impact the tariffs are having. So it is a fun part of the campaign because I get a chance to hug a lot of strangers and have a lot of great conversations.
Now, you mentioned a lot of the major issues that are at stake in this campaign there. I want to talk about you, though, for a second. You've positioned yourself. You are a moderate. You have said that you are at the exact ideological center of all 100 sitting senators. Yesterday, in the wake of suspicious packages sent to prominent Democratic figures and a media organization, I heard your colleague, the Republican Senator Jeff Flake, say that if you're a moderate, it ends up in your opponent's campaign ad, not in yours. So how do you respond to that? And what is your message to Missourians in the face of an ever-growing partisan divide?
Yeah, I think it's time to turn down the temperature. I know that I've taken votes that many people in Missouri, particularly in rural Missouri, might disagree with me. But I've also taken a lot of votes that I know they appreciate. I know they are glad that I am standing up for the proposition that we can't be destroying markets willy-nilly with these tariffs. There's ways to go after China cheaters that don't dramatically impact ag like these tariffs are. I think they like the fact that there's only four other United States senators that break with their party more than I do. I am always willing to walk to the other side of the aisle if I think it matters to Missouri. I mean, a good example is getting rid of some of the regulations on small community banks and credit unions. That really matters in rural Missouri. If we're not careful, if we didn't reduce those regulations, we were going to end up with five big banks, and that's it. And nothing that farmers need more than a local banker who knows them and understands the ups and downs of every growing season and the cash flow issues. We don't need some bank out of Chicago trying to bank all of Missouri's farmers. So I stood up to the left in my party and joined Republican senators and Republican congressmen and said, yeah, we've got to pull down some of these regulations that are really hurting community banks. I know that is important to agriculture because agriculture is the most important part of the Missouri economy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, agriculture is, like you said, it is Missouri's number one industry. And you are facing a difficult challenge from Josh Hawley, who is picking up quite a bit of support in rural areas. So what do you say to people like Hawley who say that you are a liberal senator who sticks with Nancy Pelosi, only goes to the left? You say, well, that's not fair. I'm sticking with my values with health care. What's your response?
Well, it's bull manure. That's what it is. It is just not true. And frankly, no campaign has had as many false ad checks as the Hawley campaign. I didn't vote to raise people's utility rates. I voted against. I was opposed to cap and trade. Mm-hmm. I didn't. The vote they refer to in that ad on the utility rates is one where I voted to allow debate on the bill. I think I've been out in frankly, I've spent more time in rural Missouri than Josh Hawley has in the last 2 years. Josh Hawley hasn't gone to as many rural communities and opened the doors and said, anybody come in and ask me any questions you want. I guarantee you he hasn't spent as much time talking to farmers around this state as I have about the challenges they face. I know that the next generation of farmers, that we've got to get high-speed rural broadband, not just for the farm families, but also the other families that want to stay in rural Missouri and can't do it if they don't get high-speed rural broadband. That's why Roy Blunt and I have worked together to bring more money to rural broadband in Missouri. So I think there's a number of issues that people out there know I'm on their side on. And I think that, you know, the political consultants said, just call her names, call her a D.C. liberal, say she's... I vote with President Trump half the time. Mm-hmm. He signed 38 of my bills into law because I do work across the aisle. So I'm hoping voters in all parts of the state pay attention to the facts and not some of the political BS.
Okay, and what do you want voters to have in their minds when they wake up on November 6th? What do you want to think this is why I should vote for Claire McCaskill?
Well, I'm going to protect Medicare and Social Security. I'm going to continue to stand tall for middle-class families in this state, for ag families in this state. I'm going to continue to be somebody who hangs out in the middle, kind of like Missouri. And I think that's what our founding fathers wanted. They wanted people that were willing to compromise, not just say the other side stinks. And if it weren't an election year, and you ask my Republican colleagues, in fact, Pat Roberts, the chairman of the Ag Committee, actually said, if you want to get something done on a bipartisan basis in Washington, call Claire McCaskill. He and I together got the agriterrorism bill done. He and I together are protecting some of the ag investments that are being made in the Midwest. And I'm proud that I had that working relationship with Republican senators. Now, they're not going to say it in election year, but if it wasn't an election year, they'd all tell you that they can work with Claire. And I look forward to continuing to work for them, for all of Missouri's families, especially where my roots are. I mean, my father's family had the feed mill in Houston, Missouri when I was a child. And I grew up in a rural community. And so I know how important rural communities are to the state I love. And I will always, regardless of whether Farm Bureau endorses me or not, I'll always be fighting for the individual farm families in our state.